Hi, hello students, welcome to SPV Education World. Together we create a better world. If you are not yet subscribed to our channel, kindly subscribe to our channel. And also this is my initiative to help all the rural students and also provide a competitive exam coaching for free in all the multilingual languages as usual, Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, English. My dear friend, if you want to learn something in my channel, you kindly visit our playlist so that I am organizing every topics in playlist. I am trying to provide all the topics which are helpful to the all the students. My dear friends, actually I am also from a rural background, hardly educated to learn myself, so I thought my education must help and many others. So this is my initiative to help others. My dear friends, you are also part of it so that you can share it with your friends, family, or any of them, those who are struggling to learn, so that they can learn. My dear friends, and in future I'm trying to build it bigger and help many students. My dear friends, so you can also being part of it and be part of its growth. My dear friends, kindly subscribe. And also if you wish to contribute to our channel for the development, you can contribute through Paytm number that I had been provided. Okay, my dear friends, today we're gonna see about geography. This is a new course on geography that I'm gonna deal, my dear friends. I had started this, so we can see here, friends, in today's topic we shall see what are all the syllabus, and after seeing the syllabus then you can go proceed to the one by one topics, my dear friends. But one thing I assure you, my dear friends, before learning any topic, you just go through the syllabus. What are all the topics that you need to learn regarding the top that subject? Okay friends, we shall go here. What are the topics we're gonna learn in this course? In this course we'll be learning step by step, my dear friends, but thing is that I may add a few topics also. For example, certain topics will be missing, I'll be adding that. What is the use of this course? Let me explain one thing, my dear friends. What I'm providing in this course will be useful for all the competitive exam, whatever the level. I will be teaching mostly to the UPSC standard, which means IAS, IPS, for those who are preparing for that, and group 1, group 2 services, my dear friends. But thing is that even if you learn this and hear this for the time being, you'll be understanding the concept and you can attend all the courses, which means VAO or group 4 or junior assistants, such post to the IAS level for all the competitive exams. This course will be most helpful. Even you can gain a knowledge by learning it. Okay, my dear friends, here we shall see the topics that we're gonna learn in this course. We shall see here origin of earth, how does this earth originated, and structure of the earth and rotation of the earth, and next revolution of the earth, seasons, why it is caused in the earth, and latitude and longitude of the earth, a time and international datelines, classifications of rocks, materials in the earth, mountains, plateaus. If you have seen a mountain and plateau, will come to the plains, volcano, seismic waves, earthquakes and volcanic landforms. Branches of geography, which means geography has multiple branches. We shall see weathering, soil erosions, continental rift, plate tectonics, which are all the formation of the continents we can see over here, and major earth movements. Next, river, underground water and landforms, wind and sea wave landforms, glacier landforms, and next we can see ocean basins and submarine reliefs. Next we can see the ocean salinity, ocean temperature, tides, ocean currents, and current Atlantic oceans, which means different Atlantic features will be there, that will be seen. And next, atmosphere will be seen, structure of the atmosphere, insulations, heat budget. Next, temperature distribution, factors responsible for unseen distribution of temperature, distribution of atmospheric pressure, pressure belts, winds, planetary winds. And next we move on to the next 41st topic of periodical local winds, cyclones, humidity, evaporations and precipitations, types of rainfall and distribution of precipitation, factors affecting rainfall distribution, weather and climate, factors affecting climate and climate types. These are all the main topics that I want to deal. In between I'll be adding few topics which are most important. But in this playlist, you kindly visit our playlist so that you'll be clarity enough, so that it will be most beneficial for you to learn, my dear friend. After watching that, I'll be adding topics that may be missing also. Sometimes I may miss out because geography is a vast subject. There are more concepts, more than this concept, there are present. So I'll be try to add them also if I miss over anything. So future we can deal more topics. Mostly I'll be trying to provide image oriented. So to make PPTs, it may take time, my dear friends. And also I'm teaching from a rural village, so the net availability is also rare to me. I'm providing through mobile internet for you. In future, if I get any broadband and this connection, I'll be providing faster channels, which means I'll be trying to provide in live classes. If I come to live classes, it is easy and I can deal more subjects in a quicker manner, my dear friends. Okay, now we shall see What are all the branches that are present in geography? See here friends, geography is further divided into physical geography and human geography and regional geography, which means this geography deals with a physical, which means that core parts, the things we can see that physical geography. And next, if it has a human interactions, which means human has also relation with this geography, that relation between human and geography is correlated and given as human geography. And this, then we shall see the regional geography. There are certain other parts also, biogeography like that, many concepts are there my dear friends. Those things we can see here. Now we shall see here physical geography. In physical geography, it is further divided into astronomical geography, geomorphology, where we can see the landforms and these things, climatology, soil geography, and next oceanography. You'll be reading about ocean and these things, and biogeography, mostly it has environment concept. In human geography, we'll be seeing about population geography and anthropogenic geography, and next political geography, social geography, and cultural geography, and economic geography. Economic geography is further divided into agriculture, trade, transport, industry. And next, historical geography, wherever the history has and its influence over the geography. And next we see the settlement geography, where a rural and urban patterns will be reading my dear friends. And next, if you come to the regional geography, here it will be macro region, where you read about a large region as a whole with a geographical influence. And next, a meso regional, and next micro regional geography. These are all the concepts that we'll be dealing, but I'll make more interesting in future my dear friends. But because of a constraint of time, I may not teach, because I'm providing multiple courses and I had started multiple courses. I need to run them, and also I must concentrate on my work also. Okay, now we shall see here origin of earth. This is the first topic I'll be dealing in this course. Now here, origin of earth has been originated, but did you go and see this earth, or when did this earth originated? No, we don't have any chance to go back and see how this earth originated. But thing is that the origin of earth can be dealt by different theories, which means our reverence scientists will be there. They'll be providing a more info of how the earth has been formed or originated based on the evidences that are available for us to read. Like that, there are two types: earlier theories and modern theories. Earlier theories means between there'll be eras, which means 1000 years back or 1500 years back, more scientists they had provided. But modern theories means they'll be taken ideas from the earlier theories and provide as a modern theory. Now we shall see what are all the theories and detail my dear friends. Here in earlier theories we had geocentric theory and heliocentric theory. There are multiple theories, but we'll be seeing detail and understanding just the basic concepts of the theory. You must know the theory. What does the theory had said? You would have read the theory, but if you read the theory, you don't understand my dear friend. But understand the theory, what they're gonna say. Now we shall see here earlier theories. If you come to the earlier theories, it is first we shall see geocentric theory. See my dear friend, if you need an answer, the question has the answer. Now what is geo? Geo means earth. Now we got one thing, geo means earth. Centric means what? Center. So that is the theory you need to learn here. Earth as a center. If you consider earth as a center, that is called geocentric theory. Now we shall come to the theory part my dear friend. Theory is the final form of given by Ptolemy. Who had provided this? Ptolemy had provided this theory. He belongs to Alexandria of Greece, which means Greek, which means he is an ancient scientist, an old scientist. He had provided in ancient era itself. What did he say? By his observations, he said that. Now let me show the image here. See here my dear friends, the earth is center of the universe. He thought that earth is center, whole celestial bodies are revolving around the earth. That is his assumption. So now you can see this image my dear friend. First image you can understand, the earth is center and moon is revolving around it, Venus is revolving around it, and also the sun, Mars, whole solar system is revolving around the earth. That was the theory propounded by Ptolemy. So now what did this Ptolemy said? He said that, okay, my earth is center, whole celestial body universe is revolving around the earth. That is the thing Ptolemy propounded. So sun, stars, and heavenly bodies, everything revolve around the earth. But my dear friend, now you know everything as true, that no, earth is not a center. But thing is that those times they don't know, they followed that. But after him, there he came one more theory called heliocentric theory. What is helio? Helio means, understand it, it is sun. Center means centric. Now the heliocentric theory, it is propounded by whom? Nicholas Copernicus. He belongs to Poland. He had written a book called De Revolutionibus Orbium Coelestium. So the Coelestium, this is the book he had wrote. In that book, Copernicus mentioned that Sun is center of the universe, which means, if you see the second image, this is the second image, my dear friend. What he said, that Sun is center, whole universe or whole solar system, everything is rotating around the Sun. That was the thing propounded by Copernicus, heliocentric theory. You must remember who said that theory also. Next, Earth and other planets also revolve around the Sun. And also Galileo, Isaac Newton, these are the people who supported the geocentric theory. So slowly people came to recognize that geocentric theory was wrong, but it is in modern times. But previously, understand this, my dear friend, Galileo, Isaac Newton, they also supported what? Geocentric theory, not the heliocentric theory. They criticized Nicholas Copernicus, which means they didn't believe in Copernicus, but what Copernicus said had become true in future days. Okay, my dear friends, now we shall see next theories of, see here, let me show the image. Now we are seeing modern theories. In modern theories, from Buffon's hypothesis onwards, we'll be seeing, my dear friends. So we shall see that now Buffon's hypothesis. What is Buffon's hypothesis tell about origin of Earth? Now let me, my dear friend, I'm teaching whatever the theories, everything is dealing about origin of Earth. How did Earth originated? Because everybody have their own ideologies, so they say their own ideologies, but nothing can be true, because even a latest trusted theory can go wrong, because theories are never proved, so they are assumed, so they will be changing day to day. But you must know, what does that hypothesis say? Buffon's hypothesis was propounded by Comte de Buffon. He is a French naturalist. What he said is, Earth is originated as the revolution collision between Sun and comet. See here, here is a Sun, here is a comet, both collided. After the collision of Sun and comet, the particles dissipated or came out, and the Earth has been formed. This was the theory Buffon's hypothesis indicates. But now, what does gaseous mass theory indicate? Gaseous mass theory is proposed by Immanuel Kant. Immanuel Kant, you can see here, my friends, in the second image, the person here, it is Immanuel Kant. Whatever the gaseous mass theory or nebular hypothesis, both had same said most similar things, my friend. Earth and other particles originated from a rotating nebular mass of gases. Here you can see a huge nebular mass of gases has been rotating. Because of attraction between them, those gaseous particles has converted into the matter, and Earth and other planets has been formed. This is like a Newton's law of gravitation. Based on that law they had provided, this nebular hypothesis, this Laplace has been proposed, my dear friend. Now we shall see what is nebular hypothesis. Nebular hypothesis is proposed by Laplace de Marquis. He, in his book Expositions to Systeme du Monde, this is the book that was written by Laplace de Marquis. In his book, he had clearly mentioned that nebulous theory, how it has been functioned. Intense hot rotating nebular gases cooled. Okay, see here, friends, you can see here you can see diffuse cloud, here dense cloud. These are intense and hot. This intense hot nebular gaseous cloud slowly cooled. After cooling, this rotation and subsequent centrifugal force increased further due to the decreasing volume of force. See, always whenever they started rotating, you can see the next image, they started rotating. Whenever the rotation increases, the centrifugal force means the force needed to move away from it. So slowly the masses of low volume has been moving away, and due to this centrifugal force, a ring of mass separated of nebula and transformed into planetary body. See here, after this centrifugal force, certain objects or certain particles started moving away from it, and slowly after rotating due to centrifugal force and orbital capacity, everything started rotating and forming as air planets around the Sun. This was the thing, a hypothesis by nebular hypothesis. It was said by Laplace de Marquis. Mostly this nebular and the gaseous theory, mass theory hypothesis, both has similar concepts, my dear friends. And next, a planetesimal hypothesis. What is planetesimal hypothesis? It is T.C. Chamberlain and F.R. Moulton both had proposed this planetesimal hypothesis theory. A star passed by Sun and drew out some materials which later condensed into planetary bodies. See here, if any star, now you can see Sun is there, but one more star, if it comes closer to Sun and passes over, both have attraction capacities to some particles of the sun, which means a planet is Melville will move away from the sun and form as a planetary body. This was the planetismal hypothesis propounded by Chamberlin or Moulton. And next we come to the modern theories of tidal hypothesis. What does this tidal hypothesis? This is propounded by Jean James and Jeffrey H. Both said that tides of gaseous mass from the sun created a result of high gravitational force from a approaching star or condensed from the planets. If you read just a theory, you won't understand. Come to the image, my dear friend. Here, due to the rotation of the sun, continuous rotation of the sun, there is a tidal effect produced in the sun. Due to the tidal effect, few particles moved away from the sun and slowly created the planetismal particles or planets, my dear friends. Here you can see that electromagnetic hypothesis. Now it was dealt by electromagnetic hypothesis. Who proposed that? Dr. Hans Alfven proposed this theory, and he said that electromagnetic theory are attracting the dust and gaseous mass. Always electromagnetic field has been produced by the earth or planetary particles, my dear friends. Like that, you can see in this image, earth has surrounded by electromagnetic field, my dear friends. These fields would attract the dust and gaseous masses. That dust and gaseous masses revolving around the sun in time frame, which means years together, they were rotating around the sun. Because of this electromagnetic field, they condensed and came together to form a particles called a planets. And also in later stage, these planets has been growing. So they have created their own magnetic field around them. This is an electromagnetic hypothesis that was proposed by Hannes Alfven. And next we can see that binary star hypothesis. You must read this carefully, my dear friend. Binary star hypothesis means, see here, first a nebula will be there, slowly it will be divided. After division, it will be dividing into two stars, and two stars will be rotating by themselves with a same center, which means a same center, both will be rotating in equal axis, my dear friend. In the supernova hypothesis, you can see that it was proposed by Hoyle and Littleton. Here you can see what is supernova and how a star or black hole is formed, my dear friend. This is about star formation. Slowly a gaseous particle will be there, it will be burning down, and see here, this is the stage where sun is formed, and when it grows by size, at last it will become a red giant or super giant. After that, if it have a massive star, which means it have a huge mass, then it will be going to the stage of supernova. After supernova, it has very heavy mass, means it will be converted into black hole, and if it has just a high mass, then it will be converted into neutron star. But this red giant, if it has lower mass, then it will be turning into white dwarf, and then into a black dwarf. Black dwarf means it is a dead cell. But this supernova condition is there now. From that conditions, it is proposed that as planets has been formed. And next we can see this nebular hypothesis, revised nebular hypothesis. It is provided by Otto Schmidt of Russia and Karl Weizsäcker of Germany. Both scientists collaborated to give this revised hypothesis of nebula, my dear friend. This is said that sun has surrounded by solar nebula, and it contains what? Hydrogen, helium and dust. These are all the particles that are surrounded the sun. But due to the friction and collisions of the particles led to the formation of disc-shaped cloud around the sun. So whenever the planets were formed from the process of accretion of these clouds. This is the thing, my dear friends. See here, yeah, sun is there, so it has surrounded by hydrogen, helium, dust, and due to the friction and collision between them, slowly this has been separated, and sun had a disk around it. In the disk of a cloud or particles presented, slowly it had condensed to the formation of the planets. This was said in reverse nebular hypothesis, my dear friend. But now the most trusted theory we believe in it is Big Bang theory. Big Bang theory means what? It is said that expanding universe hypothesis, which means here, my dear friend, the both image indicates the Big Bang theory. You can clearly watch it and learn it. Here a small object, small particle is there, which means small dense. Okay, we read this theory and come on, my dear friends. Here small particle has been slowly expanding. So small and dense and heavy particle. Now you can see here who proposed this Big Bang theory. It is Edwin Hubble. In 1920, he had given the evidences that universe is expanding. He had seen that the universe is slowly expanding by itself, And also he thought that before a 13.7 billion years ago, Big Bang has been happened, which means a small particle blasted. So the explosion of a small mass, extremely high density and also high temperature. This is the start or origin of the universe that is assumed by this Hubble. He said that, see here, it is small particle of small mass are extremely high density and high temperature. This Big Bang has blasted. This explosion led to the formation of the universe, which is slowly expanding by itself. The expansion still continues. That was said that here, based on the observation he had seen, that he can see that expansion is still being continuing and expands, and some energy is converted into the matter. So whenever the explosion happens, the energy is dissipated into different places. Slowly that energy has converged at one place and formed into matters. Here, and also we can see that there was a rapid expansion. Within a fraction of a second, the Big Bang had happened. There was a rapid expansion. And see here, in this, we can see that it is the fastest expansion. But in years together, which means in future, which means at the time taking, it had been greatly slowed down. And within 3 lakh years from Big Bang, the temperature dropped from 4500 kelvins, it seems, which means it had been slowly, temperature has been reducing and particles has been forming, and the whole universe is been expanding. And also this expansion is just for universe. See, the whatever the Big Bang theory insists or says, it is being said about whole universe, but not, it doesn't never support the expansion of the galaxies. Even galaxies are expanding, but that doesn't link to the Big Bang theory. That was the statement, my dear friend. And next, this is what, this is all what we see today class, my dear friends. Okay, thank you. Thanks for watching SPV Education World. Together we create a better world. If you're not yet subscribed, kindly subscribe and also donate to our channel for the development, and also help many students, my dear friend. This is part of my initiative to help many students. This is me, SP Rajan, alias SPR. So you can also be part of it by helping to the growth of this channel, my dear friends. Kindly watch the playlist so that you can learn more and you can get interesting topics together, my dear friends. This is first ever education channel to help the students in Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, English. Bye, take care. Thanks for supporting and subscribing. Signing off, SP Rajan, SPR. Bye, take care.